Hello everyone and welcome back to Genie Crafts. In today's video, we are going to see how we can create a template for a layered art in the software Inkscape and then how to create the portrait out of that template. So I received this commission order wherein the person requested three portraits, a half tone, a normal regular paper cut and a layered portrait as part of a birthday gift. So before I proceed, many happy returns of the day to Meghna Tejasi, whose portrait I have created. And now let's get started into how I created this template into Inkscape and how I created the portrait out of it.
So guys, to start with, first you need to open the software Inkscape. This is a freely available software that you can download from internet. It is available for both Windows and Mac. So open the software and you will see a default window of a new document. So click on new document, which will open a new document window for you. If you want to move your canvas, then you can click the middle mouse button. You can keep it clicked and you can drag with the middle mouse button and you will be able to drag your template. If you want to zoom in and zoom out, then press Control key on your keyboard and then use the scroll wheel button of the mouse to zoom in and zoom out of your canvas. If you want to change it to landscape mode from portrait mode, press Control Shift D on your keyboard, which will open the document properties, and from there you can select the orientation as well as the different paper size with which you want to work with. So for me it's A4 and my image is also in portrait size. So I'm simply going to leave these options unchanged and I'm going to close this window. Now the first thing that you will need to do is to import the image with which you want to create the layered template. So to import the image, click on the file menu and from there click on import and select the image for which you want to create the template. Now it is good if you have an image from which the background is already removed, because it reduces the number of unnecessary colors in the background. So this is an image for which I had already removed background using online utilities. So I'm simply going to click, select that and click open. Once again, do not make any changes to the default option. Inkscape analyzes the incoming image and presents the best options as it is. So click OK. Now as you can see that this image is way more larger than the document that I have. Since I do not plan to do anything with this document, so it's okay if you do not reduce the size or do anything with it. I'm simply just going to zoom out a little bit more so that I have more white space here on the left. Now keeping this image clicked, this is the image that I want to create layered template for. So I'll select this image, then I'll go to the path menu at the top and I'll select trace bitmap. Now this is the menu that is utilized to create stencil out of the incoming images or the image that you have imported. There are two types of stencil. One is your regular portrait stencil, for which I have made so many videos using online utilities. That is a single scan, so you are always going to get a black and white output through this. But since we are looking for a layered portrait, so we'll go on multiple scans, and since we want a colored layer portraits, we are going to select colors. Now let's talk about the different options that you see on screen. The total number of scans that you see basically represents the total number of layers that are going to come in your output. So I want a 6 layered portrait, and out of which one is the background, on top of which rest of the layers are going to sit. Smooth basically it applies a Gaussian filter to your image, which results in a smoother layer template. You won't see those sharp jaggy edges or very complex edges to the different layers. So always keep smooth selected, and also always keep stack selected so that all the layers come on top of each other without any gap. Remove background. If you will remove the background, then what will happen is that you won't have a background color on top of which your rest of the work is going to come. So I normally keep this unchecked because I want the background to be. Next is speckles. Speckles is small spots, small circles, dots that you see on your template. It's to remove that. Now you can keep it low if you want a complex template with more details, and you can keep it high if you want a less complex template or a simpler template with lesser details. So I will show you with both the details. First, let me simply keep it the default value of 2. Smooth corners, just like the Gaussian filter, it is going to make the corners more curved, less jagged, and you know, less sharp and pointy edges will be lesser and lesser if you select this. The maximum value that it can take is 1.34, so I'm going to go for the maximum value here. Optimize is also the total number of nodes. The smoothness of the outline of any layer, it will depend upon how many nodes are there. The higher the number of nodes, the more details will be on the outline. The lesser the number of nodes, the more straight lines you are going to see in your template outline. So I'm going to go for the maximum value for this, which is 5, and I cannot go beyond that. Once you are done with that, then you can click on update and it will show you a preview here. And this is how your template is going to look like. So I'm simply going to apply, and then I'll keep that template aside to compare it with a simpler version also. So give it some time to generate the template. Now this rounded rectangle you see at the back end, this is the result of me not removing the background. Had I removed the background, then this background would not have come. Now let's select the image again, and this time let's go to the maximum value, which is 1000. Now with 1000, what you will see that all these, let me just enlarge it, all these minute details that you are seeing on the layer template, now these are going to go away. And to show you, I'm just going to simply apply the template again and wait for it to render. Let me show both of them side by side how much difference the speckle option makes. And here we have two templates, and you can see the difference, the amount of details that you have lost, and it becomes simpler. So if you are short on time, you can select the more speckles option. If you have enough time, then you can select a complex option. It entirely depends on you how much detail you want. When I say details, it's not going to drastically change the final output of your layered portrait, but it is definitely going to make it much easier for you to work with. So I would suggest that you choose this option carefully. And let's say that this is the one which I want to go with, the simpler one. So I'm going to select this and delete it. This image is also no longer of my use, so I'm going to delete that also. Now, right now, you are able to drag it completely, all the layers, because it is a single image. So you need to separate the layers. For that, right click on it and select ungroup, which will now divide your single layers into multiple layers. And now you can click on each layer and start dragging them separate. So we're starting for the topmost layer, layer number 6, then 5, then 4, then we have 3, then we have 2, and we have 1. And right now you can export each image separately as a JPG or a PNG, and you can take separate printouts. In the previous methods that I had shown, you had to apply a little bit of logic as to what areas to cut and what areas not to cut. Here it is very simple. Whatever is a colored area you have to keep, everything else you have to cut out. So you start with the bottommost layer. The layer numbering is very easy to identify. The layer with the most color is the bottommost layer, so this one. Then the next most color is the next layer, then next, next and next. So there is no chance to get confused anyway. And you can always refer to the template, so you will know that which layers come after which. So once you are done, whatever layer you want to save, click on it. Then click on export PNG image, select export as, and select any location where you want to save. So I already have the layers saved with me, so I'll show you how they look. So this is how the layers are going to look, and you can always take a separate printout directly on the craft paper. This time you don't even need to take on a separate paper then put on top of your craft paper, so you can work with this.
So guys, here's the printout for the separate layers. As you can see, having separate images for each layer makes it easier to take printout directly on the colored craft paper, and that is what I have done. And now it's time to cut each layer and then paste on top of each other. So that I have already covered in other videos, so I'm not going to focus much on that. You simply need to remove all the non-gray areas on each layer, since this was a black and white printout. So you have to keep all the dark areas and you have to remove all the light areas on each layer, and then paste on top of each other. So I'll start with the layer number 1. I'll show you a time lapse, then I'll show you how to connect it with layer number 2, and so on. For cutting, I am utilizing Olfa paper cutting knife, and I have taken the printouts on 220 GSM thick textured colored craft papers. So here is the cutout almost ready for the first layer, which is actually the second layer because the first layer is the background layer. So now that this cutout is ready, I'm going to show you how to paste it on top of background layer, and in a similar fashion you have to keep on pasting the other layers on top of each other. When you are applying the glue, do not apply too much of it, and also you don't need to apply the glue over the entire surface of your layer. You can just apply on the edges or on the corners that are very fragile and some places in between. It's important that you do not apply too much glue, otherwise your paper is going to warp and it is not going to give that crisp, clean finish. Also, you can see that I am using water-based glue, but if possible utilize PVA glue because they tend not to warp the paper. Unfortunately, I ran out of PVA glue, so I had to utilize this water-based glue. And we are done with the first two layers, and in a similar fashion we have to complete the rest of the layers. And we are done with all the layers, and now the only thing remaining is to remove that excess gray background that you see across the image. Since my original image did not contain any background, so I have to remove this, and that is the next step.
So guys, this is how you create a layer template in Inkscape, a very quick and simple way to do that. I hope you guys found this tutorial useful. If you guys like the video, then please don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends. Also, do subscribe to my channel for regular videos on paper art, and I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Till then, stay safe, take care, and bye bye.